Hi everyone and welcome to the video series of the Python crash course. So let's start. Let me highlight this again. This is not a overview of programming in general, it's just Python crash course. So let us concentrate into Python. So what are the data types in Python? There are seven named data types in Python. Those are numbers or the numeric data type, strings, lists, dictionaries, booleans, tuples or tuples, people say, whatever you want, sets, and these are the seven data types that are used in Python. So now let me talk first about the numbers. So let's get into it. So Python in the numbers or the numeric data type, numeric, because in some notebooks it is written as numeric. So the numeric type contains four types of numeric data type. Those are integer, like we can take example 007, James Bond, isn't it? Or -7, -10, -10. These numbers, these are all integer numbers because they are signed numbers. So, and the range is, it's kind of a phone number, I don't remember, 2, 1, 4, 6 and a 4, 7 and a 4, 8 and a 3, 6 and a 4, 7, comma, copy the same, and do it 48 and put a minus here. So this is the range. If someone asks, you can tell him this. If someone's phone number is this, don't mind, I'm not using this. So check this, that it is starting by from 2. So what if it becomes 3? Then Python is a dynamically typed language, isn't it? Like PHP or any other language, we don't have to give that variable about which type of variable, which type of data it is going to store. So it is dynamically assigned. So if we put a number like, this is a 10 digit number, so this will come in long. Long also comprise of negative numbers because it's just the long variant of integers. I don't remember its range and it's not required anyways. So coming to float, what are float? Float are decimal point decimal numbers or floating point numbers like 0.07 or 0.007. Put how many zeros you want. 7, 7.00007. You can do it. So this is float. And remember guys, float numbers can be negative, also scientific, zero e, somewhat something, scientific numbers. And here comes the new data type for other language programmers, the complex data type. So let me tell you guys, what is the syntax of a complex number in maths? It's A plus IB or BI, you say. This we all must have read it in class 9 or 10 maybe. So in Python its syntax is A plus BJ. So now a question arises here, why aren't we using I? Because I is kind of, if we use I here, it will throw an error, it will show us error, because I is, what should I say, it's kind of a keyword, you think, like we use int, like we use long, we cannot use that here. So we cannot use I, it is, I think, conserved or preserved for some other tasks. So it is already predefined in Python. So that's it for the numbers part. Now let's get into the part where we'll code, we'll use this in the term in the shells. So first of all, let me give you important note guys, that in Python these shells don't require, means in any Python you use any editor, anything, Python basically doesn't requires a code construct, like, let me remove this for a second, like this, for beginning we don't need main method. We also don't need a class. So do remember guys, these are not mandatory in Python. Python can straight work like this. It is working too, isn't it? Let me change this so that you don't think that this is scripted or it is fixed to that only. So these can directly be run. I'll be talking about those main function and classes later. So I told you that because I don't want you guys to be confused. So now let's do the integers. Like, we are doing integers here. And how do you check that these are integers or not? So there is a method we can use for any data type that we are passing. Suppose we pass 2, it shows it is int. Suppose we pass a long number, it should also be int, because long is not written in Python, but it is converted into long, don't worry. And suppose we write one more thing like 0.9, or our best example 007, why not? So it's returning us float. So this is a method type which can be handy in identifying which data type are we using. Let us do a complex. See, it's returning us complex. So this can be done. For now, let it be 1 plus 1. So see, now I did some basic functions here. You guys can see it's zoomed. You can pause and you can do this. We can directly run expressions in it by using some method. By using this, we can use floats in between. We can mix Python or itself typecasts the type of thing we are doing. Means the highest data type, means the highest priority data type, I should say. So I kept these 3 blank spaces because I wanted to do some random stuff, like complex is a new data type, so why shouldn't we try a complex number? You can do multiply by 4, or if you multiply it by a 4j, means it's another complex number, that is 0 plus ij. For better clarification, let me write it like that. And now if we do this, those who can solve this can do this one. We put brackets here, bodmas who applies, add something, few things change. Do this guys, play with numbers, and do remember, don't leave these blanks, okay? These blanks should be filled. And I would be putting that in the description box. And this file, means the data types file, I think I would be putting it in a text or Python format if I can. It would be available in the description box. Those who are using Jupyter Notebook know this, that you can go to this file and download, as you can download it in any kind of files if you want. So don't worry, I won't be giving a Python notebook, I'll be giving a Python file. So thank you guys. Keep watching, keep learning.